Good. Uh-huh.
Kenya's education sector receives a big chunk of Kenya's national budget, especially for financing the free primary education program. Despite increasing enrollment in public schools, the education sector still faces persistent challenges, largely owing to low awareness levels among community members on the specific roles of education stakeholders.
Things were running without a lot of understanding. There was a gap between school head teacher and the school management committee. Even you would hear uprising from schools, parents going against the teacher, saying the head teacher has done this.
The Basic Education Act 2013 seeks to promote and regulate free and compulsory basic education through measures such as the establishment and functioning of a Board of Management, BOM, for each public school. Among other functions, the BOM is tasked with promoting quality education for all pupils, ensuring and assuring the provision of proper and adequate physical facilities, and promoting the best interests of the institution and ensuring its development. Whereas the government underscores the participation of parents by allocating 6 out of the 14 official positions in the BOMs, not many parents were well empowered to ensure accountability in basic education service delivery. World Vision Kenya found a solution to this dilemma through the utilization of the Citizen Voice and Action CVA approach. CVA approach empowers communities and government to work together to improve basic services that are critical for the well-being of children and their families.
It is empowering the citizens to voice out the issues. They can listen when a parent comes out and says, this is the gap that we have in our school, and how can we move together to ensure that our children achieve education.
It transforms the dialogue between communities and government in order to improve services such as education that impact the daily lives of children and their families. World Vision Kenya, through its Yata Area Development Program in Machakos County, employed the CVA approach in its basic education project.
Free primary education does not come to lift all the responsibilities made for the parent to the government or to the teachers. So that is something that the CVA can be able to address, because it is community communicating to the fellow community members.
World Vision works with various partners in Yata sub-county, among which is a community-based organization known as MANDA, which coined its name from Matu and Dalani zones, where 20 schools were selected in the pilot phase of the project.
We've been engaging our parents and creating awareness to them, mobilizing them, showing them and helping them understand the importance of attending parents' meeting in schools, supporting the head teacher, enrolling their children in school, and the importance of providing their children the basic needs in the school.
World Vision had organized a seminar for the head teachers, and here we clearly defined the roles of head teachers. And we also showed them the need for them being transparent in all areas as concerns financial management, and also being closer to their teachers and also close to their parents.
MANDA uses the CVA approach to compare the reality on the ground to government's stated commitments to education.
We have the questions and categorize the respondents: the pupils, parents, teachers, BOM, the head teacher.
This approach enhanced awareness among administrators, teachers, parents and pupils on their respective responsibilities. Whenever schools received the FPE funds, parents were called for a meeting through the Board of Management to prioritize projects and improve expenditure.
Amujambo.
Amujambo.
Kuhusu pesa za shule ambazo zimeingia kama zile za vitabu, wiki jana kamati ilikutana na walimu na wazazi ambao wanahusika katika kamati hiyo, mwenyekiti ni deputy, na wakaangiza vitabu ya karibu 190,000.
Walimu wanatuita tukajadiliana tutafanya hivi. Saa kila mzazi akawa anajibanga akatolea mtoto wake chenye mwalimu anahitaji.
The views of the parents are implemented by the committee.
And up to now, I may say that the learning parents now, they are coming up. I can rate them at 70% supportive of school issues.
Dalani Primary School did not have a fence a few years ago, but through the parents' cooperation, a fence has been erected to protect the school from intruders. At Monina Primary School, this was the unsuitable conditions the little ones had to endure 3 years ago. Big desks meant for pupils in upper classes also served as beds to lie on when they felt sleepy.
Parents participated in buying the mattress for nursery one to sleep at noon, buying books, chairs, independent chairs. Then before we used to sit on desks, children used to fall, but now we use the chairs and tables.
The then long queues at the few playing facilities have also reduced with the erection of more facilities.
Kama wazazi tunajukumu kuhakikisha ya kwamba mtoto anaishi maisha yale mzuri akiwa nyumbani na pia shuleni. Mambo yale serikali haitafikia kwa ukamilivu kama wazazi tunaingia na kusupport.
Parents also deemed it fit to upgrade the head teacher's office into an administration block and hence successfully held a funds drive to this end.
All the parents paid whatever was expected of them, around 95%, because only less than 5,000 shillings is the one that is remaining to be paid.
MANDA CBO, through the use of the CVA approach, has impressed on head teachers to display on notice boards the FPE funds received from the government and how they have been utilized to enhance transparency.
When you look at 2015, total for that year we received 75,686 and 20 cents. Then the expenditure of the textbook for the year was 75,516. If you want to learn the school very well without stress, be transparent to the teachers, to the pupils, to the parents, to anybody who will come to that school.
Hapo mbeleni, mwalimu mkuu, yule tulikuwa naye, hakuwa anapendelea mambo ya wasi, free education pants, sikija. Hakuwa anataka kutuambia mbeleni. Tutakuja tukaambiwa ile ndalasa imejengwa hii na hii, lakini hatukuwa tunajulishwa. Lakini tulipoendelea kumuuliza, hata yeye akalegebisha. Sasa hata ikiwa ni shilingi tano, anaiweka wazi kwa wazi.
Matu HGM Primary School is also another success story of the CVA approach.
This school for many years was known as a school where severally there were chaos, there were quarrels. The biggest noise came from the low performance that emanated from the lack of cooperation by the stakeholders. Soon after MANDA took over, the parents are now able to come together and participate in activity in the school.
Kama hii fence tumeweka, hiyo ni gharama ya mzazi. Stima kuweka wiring, kama tunataka darasa fulani iwekwe wiring, hatutangojea hiyo ya serikali, kwa sababu tukiweka kwa budget, tulipe watchman, kila kitu, hakuna kitu tabaki.
Its enrollment is steadily rising courtesy of its good performance in national examinations.
We had 82 candidates and the mean went up to 303.60. 71 out of 82 managed above 250, and one child managed 413, is in alliance, and around 10 had over 390. And we are rated number one public school in the sub-county. The reflection of our school is going on are the results. Where there are chaos, there are wrong results.
The Students' Council is a manifestation of a community empowered by CVA to act responsibly and demand improved services.
When we received the tanks in the school for the first time, we were so scared. Children watatoboa matanki. Tukaweka simiti, wire. But today, through the leadership of the children, we have very many tanks. Now three more tanks, and you can't hear there's a problem. They use the water. They use it well. Ikiisha, we look for water. So they have become responsible.
There is a certain school whereby, in Kivingoni sublocation, the teacher was not attending classes. The pupils took advantage
of what the CVA has told them, that the awareness which has been created to them and reported to the bombs, to the PTA members. So these small children, the pupils now, they have learned their rights. So we were to intervene, the stakeholders and the parents, and we talked with the teacher, and we found a way of him being transferred.
The interface meeting is a critical session in the CVA project model. After the initial meeting, the monitoring standards meeting, and the community scorecard process. Here, stakeholders share the information from the monitoring standards and scorecard processes with a broader group.
Service delivery status. Majority of parents were aware of learning materials availability in schools, citing poor condition in the same. All schools except Nanzaani have no feeding programs. And recommendation, the national government should decrease funds for purchase in learning materials. The county government and well-wishers should reduce school feeding programs.
Based on this information, the community, government, and service providers create an advocacy action plan to improve the services monitored.
If children had feeding program in school and they feed on the same staff, they would feel a little bit more equal. A child can even get convinced that if Mumu is a child and I'm a child and he eats chapati when I eat githeri, he might do better because he's eating a better diet than I am.
I understand when we talk about sanitation, we are talking about latrines, and they are in critical condition, which means the pupils are leaving themselves in the bush, or the latrines don't have shutters, or they are full.
I visited the school last week. I saw what they are talking about. It is true. The toilets are not really good. So that is why this report is very important when we are sharing with you people, even our CSOs. They'll get to know what is happening in schools.
As a result of these four processes, communities have a wealth of information about what the government has promised to do and what exists in reality. Communities also build essential relationships that strengthen civil society and begin to form action plans that will allow them to change the condition of the services upon which they depend on a daily basis.